McBurnie! Welcome to Bramall Lane, Ollie McBurnie. You are most welcome.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to another episode of Uncut.
Today we are joined by Sheffield United's Oliver McBurnie.
Yes, let's get started.
In front of you, you should have some pictures of some players, you know, that you've played with internationally at club level. We want you to rate them, but you have to pick one player over the other, and it's going down on fashion. So the first two I have on my screen here is a beautiful looking Ollie McBurnie and John Egan.
Okay, so this is the photo of me.
I mean, you got the hat, you got the Jordan ones on. We see some colour coordination
everything
going on.
Everything just works there. Everything just works there, right? And then we got this that you're comparing that with me. Is that what we're doing?
Yeah. Hey, hey. Hey, that's a fine, good-looking Cork man there. With his hurley and his slitter. Do you know what I mean? He's back home in his father's land in Kerry. Do you know?
Eags is a very good-looking man, but there's only one winner there, and I take that absolutely. Absolutely, there's no contest.
Okay, so John Egan is out. The next up, we're going to do you against Andy Robertson. You've got to give Andy some credit here.
He's had a right go. He's got a little three piece on. I'd give him like a 6 out of 10 there.
Oh, okay.
A 6?
I'm not sure about the waistcoat with the jacket there, the black waistcoat with the grey, and then he's got the old polka dot tie with a check blazer on. He's got a bit too much going on there, Dave, you know what I mean?
Okay.
He needs to kind of stick with one thing.
Who are you picking? Yourself or Andy Robertson?
It's close, Robbo. You're looking well, pal, but I'm gonna take this one. I'm sorry, Paul.
Ooh, and we'll move on now to Phil Jagielka.
He needs a tailor. A bit baggy for me. He's got the old open-done polo. Is he going to play golf there, or is that... It's a strange one for me. I don't think the colours are really working.
I presume you're going to pick yourself over...
Yeah, I'm going to have to pick myself there, mate. It's not really a test, that one.
Okay, the next one up is another photo of Ollie McBurnie.
So it's me be me?
Yeah.
Going to be a tough one, this.
Now, which outfit are you picking?
You've done me a disservice here because you've missed off the trainers on this one as well. If the trainers are in this photo, this one wins.
So what trainers were you wearing then?
Shall I go get them?
Go on.
One sec.
Oh! Yeah, we like those. So,
you know what I mean? So they've got the yellow with the yellow, and then one black lace, one yellow lace. It was real good. So if I've got the trainers with it, this one wins.
The next photo is Scott McTominay.
Yeah, the only thing he's got going for him there is the bear, really, if we're being honest, innit?
You're not having Scott's gear, no?
Nah, that's miles off it, mate. The whole thing, top to bottom, he's really struggling. It's like he's trying to have a bash, but he's not really, do you know what I mean? He's still gone safe. I don't like it. Get out your comfort zone, Scott. You can do better.
It's pretty obvious to say that Ollie McBurnie wins that round.
All day long, mate, all day long.
Okay, next up, you or KT?
We know the answer to that one, eh?
I'm definitely picking Rod over you anyway.
Rod's got half a chance, mate, but KT's got zero chance. Has he gone there with a green blazer and a white shirt, done up to the top with a collar? It's not for me, mate, if I'm honest.
So, next up, you should have a photo of Lise Mousset.
Here's a man who I can respect. He's looking all there. He's got his brands matched. He's got his nice little watch on, pair of sunnies. Yeah, I'm gonna give Moosey. Moosey's had a little go there. I'm gonna give it to Moosey.
Finally, we found someone who tops Ollie McBurnie.
Tops on par is my friend. I'll give him.
And then the final photo we have is a young Ollie McBurnie. Now I'm curious to know. You gave KT a bit of stick for his top button tied. You now have your top button tied.
The difference, I think, I'm more of a that's a polo. And I think KT's gone with the shirt tied up with, you know, he should have a tie on it or something. I don't know what he's gone for there. That's more of a polo, which I think you've got to do top button up. I'll give it to Moose. Go on, Moose can take the title on there. Lise can have it.
He feeds McBurnie!
So I want to know what kind of music you've been listening to. And we're starting with the gym?
When I'm in the gym, I'd go Giggs, Talking the Hardest.
That's my favourite Giggs tune ever.
Yeah, it's my favourite song as well. But then I'd go like right to the opposite end, and I'd go like Red Hot Chili Peppers.
All right.
And then I'd go Arctic Monkeys, From the Ritz to the Rubble. Just upbeat, like, get me going, do you know what I mean?
That's all like active, I like that. But if I was to go back to Giggs, Talking the Hardest, if I was to say to you, if you're talking the hardest, Giggs better pop up in your thoughts as an artist, what are you gonna say? Yeah. Yeah. All right, what do you listen to right before you play a match?
I'm more chilled out for pre-match. A lot of the boys like to get pumped. So like, my music's not on in the Sheffield United dressing room because it's all like, before a game, it's all proper pumped up. But I just like, that's when I'd go for my chill out music. So that's when it'd be like Drake, Lil Baby, like A Boogie With A Hoodie. That's where like I'd just relax and I'd like get in my own zone. So sometimes I might put my own headphones in and just chill out to that music while the boys can have their like deep house music going on that they've got going on there.
What about post-win, after you win a match?
Then like it's got to be that upbeat, so like Sister Sledge, Thinking of You.
Nice.
But Luther Vandross.
Ooh, okay, we like it.
Yeah, just like get the vibes going, get all the old school good vibes going in the dressing room. That's what we kind of go for. We're all on the same page with that one at Sheffield United, to be fair.
What about when you're playing FIFA?
To be fair, I'm more of a concentrating man when I'm playing FIFA, so I really need to get into it. But if I was going to have something on in the background, I'd probably just go with a playlist, so... It'd probably be Tupac, Drake or Lil Baby. They're my three like go-to artists that if I'm just having on in the background when I don't really need to listen too much.
All right, and finally, what are you listening to on your rest day?
Recently, I've been listening to a lot of the Smiths. I just put the Smiths on full blast. I really get down. I'm really feeling the Smiths lately. So like just before I was on here now, I just had the Smiths blasting. So I'm going to say the Smiths.
All right, I need to get into it. I feel like your playlist is very eclectic.
Yeah, I got everything. Like, I just don't really like stick to one genre. I just if I like a song or an artist, then I'll just listen to it. So
yeah,
I'm not really kind of open-minded when it comes to music. I just like music.
McBurnie, he's done it.
What we're gonna do now is ultimate teammate. We'll start, say, with Pace.
It's two people that pop into my head when it comes to Pace, and one's Adama Traore.
Jimenez looks for Traore, who will run and run and has a chance to seal it, which he takes.
And then the other one, my mate Dan James. But I'm going to give it to my mate Dan James because he's my mate.
Right, next one is passing.
Scholes. Yeah, I just can't really think of many better players than him in terms of passing, man. It was ridiculous.
What, short, long?
Whatever you want, mate. Wherever you want it, he can pass you the ball, mate. Whatever you want, there you go.
Next one, shooting.
I don't think you can look really far past Harry Kane. You know, I think right foot, left foot, inside the box, outside the box. I think he's up there.
Oh, it's another majestic finish.
I'll give that one to Harry Kane, yeah.
Now, the big question that always comes up is, Alan Shearer has the goal scoring record for 260 goals.
Yeah.
Do you think Harry Kane, who's now 27, can go and break that record?
Yeah, in a word, I think he can. It's funny because we was looking at clips of him the other day, actually, and I was speaking to the analyst and I said, how many goals did he get last season? And I think he said 16. He was out for however many months in the season and he still scored 16. The only thing that would stop him breaking that record, if I'm honest, is unfortunate injuries, which, you know, touch wood, he doesn't pick up any of. So I think if he stays fit and healthy and carries on playing at the highest level, then yeah, I don't see why there's any reason why he wouldn't break that record, yeah.
Next one up is dribbling.
It was been between Henry and Giggs that I would go for. I prefer Henry, so I'll go for Henry. If he's not the best player ever to play in the Premier League, he's definitely in the top three for me.
Okay, so the next one I have is defending.
There's three that come to mind for me, like that I can remember watching, and one's John Terry, one's Rio Ferdinand, and one's Vidic. I think as an out and out defender without the football inside of it, I loved Ferdinand and Vidic because I thought Vidic was such a good defender, and then Ferdinand could do everything else. He was rapid. I'm gonna give it to John Terry because every striker that I've spoke about that's ever played and said who's the hardest centre half that you've ever played against, they've always said John Terry to me, so I'm gonna say John Terry.
Wonderful equaliser by the Chelsea captain.
The last one, I know you said you spend a lot of time in the gym.
I could be up there, you know. What is it, physicality?
Physical, yeah.
I could be up there. I feel like I could be up there now. You know, big Virgil could be up there, you know. He's the one player where the ball's up in the air and I've tried to leave one on him while neither of us are looking, and it usually gets them a bit off balance, and I kind of bounced off him, which was a real eye-opener for me. I had to go play off the other centre-half for the rest of the game. Like, that's the first, when you said physicality, the first one that came into my head was Van Dijk.
Van Dijk to the rescue.
Now, what I want you to do is rate your player out of 99. So use all the attributes and the players you've picked and rate them out of 99.
Yeah, well, he's got to be 99, surely. I'm giving him 99 because I think each one of them players has got 99 in them, in that attribute. So, yeah, my player's 99.
Well, I'm not going to disagree with you. You've got the best of everything. Do you know what I mean? If you picked McBurnie at physical, then maybe we would have come down a little bit.
It'd have been like an 84.
Anyway, Ollie, that's it for me.
Thank you. It's been fun.
Lovely. It's great to see you again. And I'll see you all soon. All right, thanks for having me.
So guys, a big thank you to Oliver McBurnie and Sheffield United, but also we've got some brand new videos available on the channel, which are based on the FIFA 21 stats. So we're gonna have the 10 fastest players in the Premier League, we're gonna have the 10 best finishers in the Premier League, and the 10 best passers in the Premier League.
Yeah, so make sure you guys check that out, and also don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and ring that bell.